The rivalry between baboons and lions. Baboons are some of the world's largest monkeys. There are 5 species of the baboon: olive, yellow, chacma, guinea, and sacred, scattered across various habitats in Africa and Arabia. The olive baboon is the most extensively distributed of the baboon family. The baboon, like other Old World monkeys, does not have a prehensile gripping tail, meaning their tails are not used as a hand, but they are still able to climb when necessary. They all have dog-like noses, powerful jaws, sharp canine teeth, and thick fur. Males have a longer mane around the neck, called a ruff. Males of the largest species, the Chacma baboon, average 66 pounds, 30 kilograms or so, but females are only half this size. The smallest is the Hamadryas, or sacred baboon, with males weighing about 37 pounds, 70 kilograms, and females only 22 pounds, 10 kilograms, but this still places them among the largest monkeys. Baboons range from 20 to 45 inches, 50 to 115 centimeters long, not including the 17 to 27 inch, 45 to 70 centimeter tail, which is carried in a characteristic arch. All species have long snouts with the nostrils located at the end. Male baboons have long dagger-like canine teeth. If you've liked this video so far, I invite you to stay until the end, so you will discover things about the rivalry between the baboons and the lions. Specifically, you will discover, why do baboons steal lion cubs? Unlike most monkeys, few baboons live in tropical forests. Most are found in savanna and semi-arid regions where they rove on the ground. They regularly climb trees, however, and here they sleep, keep watch, and sometimes feed. Baboons eat a variety of plants and animals, including grass and grass seeds, fruit, pods, roots, and tubers that they dig out of the ground. They also eat rodents, birds, and even gazelle fawns that they find hiding in long grass. In South Africa, they're said to kill lambs, and everywhere they are known as crop raiders. The 5 species of baboon replace each other geographically across the open country of Africa, from parts of the Sahara southward. The Chacma, which lives in southern Africa, south of the Zambezi River, is brown or blackish in color. The much smaller yellow baboon is found from the Zambezi northward to the Kenya coast and Somalia. The olive baboon is only slightly smaller than the Chacma and olive in color. The male has a large mane of hair over the head and shoulders. The Anubis baboon has a wide range, from the hinterland of Kenya and Ethiopia through the grasslands and Sahel westward to Mali. It is also found in the less arid highlands of the Sahara, such as Tibesti and Air. The small Guinea baboon is restricted to far western Africa, and males have a cape of hair. These 4 species are often referred to collectively as savanna baboons, and they have much in common. All live in large cohesive troops, numbering from 10 to several hundred. In most cases, females will remain with the troop in which they're born, but males nearing maturity will leave and try to join a different troop. Within each troop, there is a dominance hierarchy among adult males. They threaten each other and often fight, and the dominance ranking is constantly changing. The dominance hierarchy of females is much more stable. Females are genetically related to each other and rarely fight. Dominant members of each sex have the first choice of favored foods and mating partners. They also keep order within the troop, chasing and threatening subordinates that are fighting or otherwise causing a disturbance. The 5th species, the Hamadryas baboon, differs in appearance from the savanna baboons in that the females are brown, but males are silvery gray, with an enormous cape of hair on the neck and shoulders. Hamadryas baboons live in the semi-desert hills along the African and Arabian coasts on the Red Sea. These small groups of Hamadryas rove on their own during the day, then come back together in the evening and sleep on cliffs, not in trees like most savanna baboons. Why do baboons steal lion cubs? Baboons groom little lion cubs in South Africa's Kruger Park. A male carrying and grooming a lion cub is an unusual sight, yet it happened over the weekend in South Africa's Kruger National Park. The baboon took the cub up into a tree and preened it as if it were its own, said safari operator Kurt Schultz, who in 20 years had never seen such behavior. The baboons had gathered in an arena with granite hills and boulders, where lions and leopards have been known to hide their cubs while they go hunting, he said, and that's likely how the baboons found the cub. First, we would have to assume that animals have a sense of right and wrong. Traditionally, we human beings assume that we are the only ones who have it, but frankly, there is no proof that animals don't have it too, in some way, and plenty of indications that they do. So, let's assume for a moment that baboons are capable of discerning right from wrong. Then the answer depends on why he is stealing the cub. If it's to feed himself or his family, it is perfectly in line with natural law as applicable to him. Therefore, yes, it is moral. If it is only out of a sense of mischievousness, and there is plenty of evidence that baboons can be mischievous or cruelty, then it is immoral. Then there are questions like, for what reason would a baboon steal a lion cub? A baboon steals a baby lion that grows up to kill and eat the baboon. There would seem to be a moral to that story. Or the baboon steals and eats the lion cub because it's hungry, and the lion cub is seen by the baboon as nothing more than an available meal. Clutched in the primate's hands was a newborn lion cub, squirming with the innocence of infancy. The young baboon appeared to be grooming the lion. While it's tempting to weave Lion King-like tales of interspecies kinship, the grooming and nurturing in this case likely shadows a darker narrative, one in which the cub meets a grisly end. Baboons are omnivores, and are known to regularly eat meat when available, sometimes with frightfully grim table manners. The primates are regularly targeted by lions and leopards, so it's unlikely that a baboon would show any kind of genuine affection towards a predator, no matter how tiny it is. The baboon troop eventually disappeared into thick bush, leaving the outcome of the unusual interaction undetermined. However, later reports received via the Latest Sightings app indicate that the cub did not make it. Whether or not the cat succumbed to its captor, or simply fell victim to circumstances, is unclear. Sadly for the cub, the odds were always stacked against its survival. The cub mortality rate for lions in the Kruger Park is at least 50%. Nature is cruel at most times, and the survival of a young predator cub is not easy. The lion cub would pose a threat to the baboons when it gets older. The splendor and beauty of the natural world is often contrasted with savagery. Sadly, this little lion cub found itself on the wrong end of the scale.